Hi guys, so welcome to my channel. So today we're gonna talk about the top 5 most expensive California wines or American wines that you can find in the market right now. The wines and the label that you should try once in a lifetime. Plus in the end, however, I will give you some tips on how to avoid breaking your bank account if you cannot drink every day this kind of expensive wine. So stay with me. This is Michele Arbolato, a sommelier at your service. So in wine number 5, in position number 5, we have Opus One, one of the most famous brands of Napa Valley, one of the most famous that gave recognition to this region. And it is produced in Oakville, one of the best AVA of this region, Napa Valley. Produced by two of the most prestigious names in the wine world, that are Robert Mondavi and Rothschild from Bordeaux. And so this wine is really absolutely outstanding. It's a classic Bordeaux blend of Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Petit Verdot, Malbec, Merlot as well. Now we're gonna see a little bit more what is behind this label. And here we are with Opus One Winery, this beautiful winery, One Vision, One Wine. Look at this magnificent winery and vineyard in Napa Valley, an expression of time and place. The sense of time is expressed in Opus Wine by the character of each vintage. The terroir represents the geography, the climate, essential human element, which is captured in the wine's balance between power and finesse, structure and texture. And here the wine produced by Robert Mondavi and Baron Philippe de Rothschild on the right. Opus One is the realized dream of two men, Baron Philippe de Rothschild and Robert Mondavi. Together, our founder set out to create a single wine dedicated to the pursuit of uncompromising quality. The singular mission shapes every vintage today and for generations to come. Absolutely outstanding. Wine number 4, in position number 4, we have Arlan Estate, one of the most prestigious names of Napa Valley. Even this one comes from Oakville, from the east part of Oakville, with a better exposition also compared to Opus 1. Anyway, they started pushing immediately for super high quality. William Harlan is the founder of this estate, and they are aiming extremely on super quality. Even here we have Cabernet Sauvignon, I would say quite a lot over this episode. You can get this wine for an average price of $1,129, so not very cheap. So we jump already of 1,000 more compared to the Opus One. So, but let's see now what is behind this amazing Cabernet Sauvignon. And here we are with Arlan Estate in a magic place in Oakville. I wanted to show you a little bit the vineyard behind. And so you see 17 hectares of vines, planted Cabernet, Merlot, Cabernet Franc, a little bit Petit Verdot, sitting on both volcanic and sedimentary bedrock, combination of terraced vineyards and closely spaced to the vines. So beautiful, absolutely. They show also the vineyards quality. I wanted to show you the people behind. Here is the founder, William Harlan. Then there are the director of the wine growing, the estate director, and so on. And here the wine, they use concrete and wooden vat. Here is the wine. So if you like the video, if you like the channel, consider subscribing to my channel, like the video and click the notification bell so you won't miss any new video coming out. So for who is this channel? So I'm a sommelier, a professional sommelier, and I do these videos for you to make you understand a little bit more what is behind the wine world, how to appreciate and enjoy better the wines. where to find and where to buy the best wines in terms of price, but also in terms of value and the hidden wine gems from around the world. So if it is the channel for you, subscribe. Position number three, we have a quite unique estate that is called Sine Qua Non, that comes from the central part of California. The estate is located not too far from Los Angeles, I would say about 2 hours. However, they have vineyards a little bit all around the central coast, Santa Barbara, Paso Robles as well. But they are focused, instead of Cab, they are focused in Rhone Valley varieties. So we have Syrah, Grenache, these kind of grape varieties from Rhone Valley originally. And so that is a particular because they basically sell only by mailing list. They make by hand the bottles, labels, and you have to specifically request the wine. So it is quite unique. It's a kind of customized, super handcrafted wine. And also the website, as we can see here, it's quite simple. They go straight to the point. Here we can see the two owners. That is the guy that basically invented, started the project. And so here you can see the labels that are quite unique, quite particular. So you can get this wine for an average price of $1,400. So absolutely outstanding. Also, position number two, wine number two, probably an estate a little bit less well known at the most of us, that is Schrader Cellars. You can get their Cabernet Sauvignon for an average price of $1,700. They are located in Napa as well, and they produce Cabernet Sauvignon as well. That is the basically premium wine. So they are located in Calistoga. We are in the north part of Napa, but they have vineyards a little bit all over Napa. And the best expression of their Cabernet comes from the vineyard, very famous vineyard, Tucalon. And so here we are going to go to see now what's behind this lovely label. And here we are with the Schrader Estate Cellar. So here a bit of picture from the members of the family. This family, they are in Calistoga, beautiful landscape, I would say, even here. Look at the grape of Cabs, very, very healthy. And he is the basically the owner, the patron that started the adventure. I wanted to show now the wine. Here is the line. They are focused, of course, in Cabernet Sauvignon. For more than a decade, the cellar produced benchmark Cabernet Sauvignon from the most prestigious vineyards in Napa Valley, notably Tucalon Vineyard in Oakville. So Oakville is a kind of benchmark for all California, I would say. I wanted to show you now the wine a little bit. Let's see the latest vintage available. So from the Tucalon Vineyard in Oakville, 100% Cabernet Sauvignon, and it is aged 20 months in a rare Darnajou French oak barrel. I don't know Darnajou, what does it mean? Actually, I think it's the point, the kind of wood use, planted in 1868. Tucalon Vineyard has long been regarded as the source of Napa finest Cabernet Sauvignon grapes. Therefore, you cannot be wrong with this Schrader Cab. And then who is in position number one? So in position number one, we have Screaming Eagle. It's a cult wine from California. Oakville as well, Napa Valley, Cabernet Sauvignon. Even here we are on the east part of the AVA, of the region. So we have the vineyard facing west, and therefore we have a better sun radiation all over the day till evening. Therefore the Cabernet Sauvignon can ripe perfectly every season, every vintage, every harvest, perfectly. So they are able to provide high quality. You have to think that if they don't have the perfect condition of the grapes, they sell the grapes to other producers. They don't make their wines, or they make a second label but not the first label. And you can get this wine for an average price of $3,000. Absolutely outstanding. But you can even go higher if you find older vintage. So this is absolutely a cult wine that if you have the possibility to try once in a lifetime, go for it because you won't regret.
And as promised, I said that I wanted to give you some tips on how to avoid breaking the bank account for this wine if you cannot drink this wine every day. So, as in Italy and as in France, you can basically aim for the second basically labels that are extremely good as well, and without spending so much as for the basically first label. So basically Auber Tour is the second wine of Opus Wine, reflect the winemaker's artistry, showcasing the talent of blending five traditional Bordeaux grapes. Auber Tour, the third blending aspect that are marrying multiple vintages, yields a softer, rounder expression of our estate that can be enjoyed upon release. So basically usually they are also a little bit more approachable on their youth. They may be don't have the same character and spirit, let's say, of the first label, but they are very, very approachable, very, very elegant as well. So this is for the Opus One. Same thing is for Harlan Estate. We have the Maiden, that is their second wine, represent the second selection from the estate. It's a high detailed and sumptuous wine as well, remarkably faithful to the vineyard's pedigree, and it is basically a reassemblance of the big sister or brother label as well. Same thing for Schroeder, they have lines from other vineyards that maybe they're not so famous and prestigious as Toucalon, and you spend much less and they are much more approachable. So if you enjoyed the video, I'm sure you will enjoy also these other videos, like the top most expensive Italian wines here. Somewhere here on the screen you can check it out, and also the top most expensive Spanish wines and French wines. So I put the link here but also in the description below, and so I'm very, very curious to know if you have tried some of these wines, what you think about, and leave your comment in the description below. So I hope you enjoyed the video, I hope you got to know a few more wines that maybe you didn't know from California. I hope you had fun. If that is the case, consider subscribing and smashing the like button. This will help me a lot in making more videos. So in the meantime, I want to thank you a lot for your time, and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao!